about big gravity, and I must say that I'm sorry, but this theory is not so nice as the general relativity, but probably this is a tendention any new theory becomes not so beautiful. I see. Почему нет? Не ставит. I cannot change the page. I don't know why. What is the point out here? I see this is demonstration, this is a old joke that any new theory should be more complicated and cumbersome. I can compare general relativity. We had only one cosmological constant as arbitrary constant, but in big gravity, we have at least six of them. The ratio of gravitational constants for different metrics and the five constants from the gravitational potential. Also, we have a special kind of difficulty because our light cones, we have now not one light cone, but two. The third one is because I am not produced this picture. Third one is a geometric mean of these light cones. So of course it is more complicated, and this is has reflection in popular literature. It is necessary to mention that there are motivations. Motivations are both phenomenological, and these are very well-known problems of dark energy and dark matter, and also theoretical reason. It was interesting to construct the massive spin two field theory and interaction of it with the standard gravitation. This is a short history of the subject, and I would like to comment that it was started as massive gravity in 1939, and it was started as big gravity in 1940, and it was so that it is impossible to construct one without another. If we want massive gravity, we need second metric. And the simplest idea is to copy Lagrangian of general relativity. And when we have two such copies, we have two sets of independent diffeomorphism invariances. But it is useless to have two without interaction. We should have interaction. This interaction is Professor Volkov already said, is a combination of two metric tensors. And this combination has some invariance, for example, symmetric polynomials of this matrix. And as an example of such a construction, I demonstrate Lobunov's Lagrangian. Lobunov's potential, it contains the trace of this matrix. And these are our colleagues, which were involved in a relativistic theory of gravitation, well known here. But this theory was in contradiction with the famous idea, the famous theorem by Bohr, Werra, and Deser, that any such theory must have the ghost. For a long time, it was considered as absolutely right, but these people constructed a new potential, and the unusual idea was to take not Y matrix, but the square root of it. It occurs so that such a potential is linear under Lagrange multiplier, one of Lagrange multipliers, which provide a new constraint, and we also had secondary constraint, and the EQ to together they kill a ghost. So these are two people who founded Big Gravity, in the sense I have in mind Hassan and Fawad Hassan and Rachel Rosen. And I would like to say that there are two points which I was intended to tell you with formulas. Of course, to write formulas in such a late time is dangerous. I understand that you are very tired. But the idea is not for formulas, is that we need some background to speak about massive field or massless field. And the idea in Big Gravity is to take proportional background between the, we must have proportion between the two metrics. If we have such a proportion, it occurs so that this constant of proportionality should be constant, really. So it, first, of course, we can expect that it is a function, but it occurs a constant. It follows from Bianchi identities. And if we are considering formulas, it occurs so that for such a case, the complicated potential by Deram-Gabadaze-Tollet became simply polynomial, and it is possible to write equations for motion if we neglect matter. That it looks like Einstein equations with cosmological constants, and these constants are functions of coefficients from the potential and from the C factor, which is standing between metrics. Then it occurs so that the cosmological constants should also be proportional, and this gives us algebraic equation. This algebraic equation shows that not only C should be a constant, but also it should be a solution of this fourth order algebraic equation. So it is not very arbitrary. And the simplest case, if we consider the ground by Minkowski, then we put cosmological constants just to zero and coefficient of proportionality to unit. And we have Minkowski metric, and on its background, to get this background, we may, for example, choose the arbitrary constants in the potentials in this way. And then we get the Fields-Pauli terms in the Lagrangian or Hamiltonian. And we have a separation of two modes. One mode, which is a subtraction, gives us just massive field. And the other, which is a sum, it is not shown here. It is responsible for massless field. In more complicated case, when C is not zero and cosmological constants are not zero, we also can construct by linearization massless field and massive fields. And also massive field has minus here, but here the Fields-Pauli mass is not a coefficient which is standing in the Lagrangian, but just a function which depends on many things. For example, from constants of interaction with F field and G field with matter, and also on the coefficient of proportionality of metrics and on the functions or coefficients in the potential. So effective Planck mass now looks like this. It is a combination of the two coefficients which are standing before G Lagrangian and phi F Lagrangian. And if we write linearized equations, we can see for massless the first line and for the massive the second line. And we see if we have two kinds of matter, as Nikolai Krasnikov today already coined the term invisible world. This is a mass energy from the invisible world. This is, for example, from visible world. And for massless or for a massive, both of them are giving contributions. So about cosmology, I should say that now we have 100 years as Friedman invented his equation and his treatment of the expanding universe. And for cosmology, he considered such an ansatz. This ansatz could be made simpler if we neglect curvature. The only important function here is R. It is a scale function, a scale factor for space metric. And of course, the matter was also treated as homogeneous, isotropic, and depending on time. Then this is equation, Friedman equation, containing curvature, which we will neglect, for example. And the most important sources of gravity here of expansion of the universe are density of matter and cosmological constant, or in other words, energy density of vacuum. Then second order equation. I must say that it is very simple to solve these equations. For example, we proposed it to students, and these students were able to find, for example, point of changing epoch of radiation dominance. Radiation is green line to matter dominance, and to calculate the point where deceleration changed to acceleration. It's a simple problem available for students. And here they propose our future up to 50 billion years. What would will we have in big gravity? In big gravity, we will have a couple of ansatzes, one for G metric and the other for F metric. And they have different scale factors for space, and they have different scale factors for time. One of them we take as unit, and the other is a function. So in this treatment, in big gravity, the most important function became not one of the scale factors, but their ratio. And everything may be written as function of this scale factors ratio. Here is invisible matter energy density. We neglect it, for example, for simplicity. And then we are looking interesting. We are seeing interesting results that what is like a cosmological constant became now a dynamical dark energy, because it depends on y, and this y is a function of time. Both coefficients, both lambda constants became functions of y. But if we want to have only constants, we take only beta zero here and only beta four here. And then Hamiltonian analysis gives us the secondary constraint. And if we use secondary constraint together with these two, we can compare right-hand sides of these Friedman equations. And this is unusual situation when the energy density of universe, I hope our universe, is a function of this new variable y. This variable y is a ratio of scale factors. And so it occurs so that Energy density is not arbitrary, it is a function of this y. But really, to construct a cosmological scenario, we need to go opposite, and we must have y as a function of rho. If we have y as a function of rho, as rho is more or less observable, we put this rho and we can try to find y. There are four solutions for equation for the fourth order algebraic. And we propose to take one when these scale factors ratio tends to zero in the Big Bang situation, when density of matter is going to infinity. The other branches, possible branches, are more or less not so suitable. And for dynamics of this y, we had a simple equation. And this equation tells us that if we start from y zero, then it will be increasing, and at last n will be equal to y. It means that matrix become proportional, and we have proportional matrix, which means that they are the Sitter solutions for both matrix. And so cosmological scenario is starting from Big Bang and coming to the Sitter expansion, accelerated expansion. So this is a case of proportionality. And really, this is the same. So in principle, it is possible to calculate everything which is necessary in the evolution of cosmology. If we find y, we can also obtain rho density, density of matter. Matter means here usual matter and dark matter together, and we can calculate Hubble constant as a function of time and dark energy density as a function of time. So this is the idea of the scenario, and of course it should be it can be calculated only numerically by computers, and some people are doing this, and they are telling us that the results which gives this theory is compatible with all the observable data. So as lambda CDM model is compatible with the observable data on cosmology and on local experiments in gravitation. Also, it is possible to satisfy all the data by the big gravity. Of course, we are using the number of parameters. Those parameters, we have a lot of parameters, and so it is possible to reach this. Here, it is only addition is that someone is hoping that matter really interacts not with G mu, but with some effective matrix, which should be constructed from both of them. And for example, this construction can be done by means of the tetrads. If we take tetrads for G mu and tetrad for F mu, and the linear combination and construct metric, it is nice, but it was proved that it gives again a ghost, and so it is not so nice. And the other way to get a new metric was from the Poisson bracket algebra in Hamiltonian formalism, when we consider constraints which generate dynamics. We obtain in the nice Poisson brackets coefficient which is a metric. It is special spatial metric for space, but some people hope to get something new in this way, but it was shown that only a metric generated from G menu or metric generated from F menu may appear here asymmetric, and nothing new was obtained. And here I collect references which are saying that everything is good with the gravity. It can be used for explaining our physics if we are looking for nice values of parameters. But of course, these parameters are not defined uniquely, and it's a hard problem. I am not expert with such pictures, especially because when I'm looking at my display, I cannot differentiate between orange and red and so many colors which are here. But so I am showing it only to say that there is a space which offers, now this offers Marcus Fogas. They say that this place is a nice point for agreement with all the observable data. And at last, it is my conclusions that the gravity has motivations, both theoretical and observational. The gravity is not so nice as general relativity because it constrains a lot of arbitrary parameters. And the gravity provides solutions for self-accelerated universe, so we do not need special cosmological constant. We can get dark energy and even dynamical dark energy from here. The gravity may also has relations to dark matter, but these works are not so numerous as related to dark energy. The gravity survives all the tests, and the gravity admit limits to general relativity and to massive gravity. But anyhow, it's a hard work to prove that this may be a real physics, a real, that it may be adequate for real world. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, according to your last remark, let's proceed to the questions. From Zoom first. No questions from Zoom.
Yes. Two questions about black hole solutions. You know, one of the, let us say, main conclusion from relativistic theory of gravitation was the absence of black hole solution. So how, let us say, often people got this result in by gravity theories? So because some people are saying we have black hole solution, I mean, in the framework of biometric approach. Others said no. So what about?
No, I think that Mikhail Volkov is more expert in this field. And he said us that black holes are present, but they maybe have hair.
It's not. But question, the next question about, let us say, explanation of accelerated expansion of universe. Because if I understood properly, relativistic theory of gravity, practically, instead of lambda term, they introduced massive graviton, and after that, immediately they got accelerated expansion of universe. But in your approach, so you need more parameters to get, not only one. Is it correct?
But among these parameters, there are no especially cosmological term. It appears.
Yes.
It may not appear if we take some values of parameters.
Ah, okay.
Because they are at least five in the potential. And if we take some values,
you can call more parameters, not one.
Yes.
It's correct.
Yes, I okay. have started from this.
No, but it's, I'm repeating my understanding. Probably it's, is it correct? Okay, thank you.
Yes, no, there is, I have not mentioned, there was a problem about perturbation. It was told that some kind of perturbations of this background equations are unstable. But these people which I listed in this page, they insisted that it is possible to win this, to win over this problem by means of Weinstein mechanism. So nonlinear, they say that it is necessary to consider nonlinear effects, and these nonlinear effects are making these perturbations not dangerous.
But what about explanation for CMB? Something they did, something, some more exercises for CMB? They do.
They have a lot of work, and they say that everything is in correspondence.
Okay.
Everything is okay with this data. Okay. All data can be explained, not better, not worse than lambda CDM model.
Now,
am I right that it's not the graviton mass which is responsible for the accelerator expansion? It's not the zero. Yeah, because the value of the graviton mass is much smaller than the inverse Hubble. Yes.
It may be different. They say that it is possible to vary. What we mean by graviton mass? What can be obtained in the proportional motion?
The mass. There was a plot.
This
is it the mass of graviton?
Yes, in this.
So 10 to minus 33 is smaller than Hubble. Yes.
Yes,
it means that this graviton is smaller than the Hubble. It's not enough to explain the, you know, the beginning of gravity at large scale. So you need something else. Just I mean, numbers.
I cannot make the numerical arguments, but. What I have read from these people, they say that it is possible to take even great graviton masses, but if we change other parameters, it's possible to make graviton mass more than these figures, but other parameters should be arranged.
It's not the final, I mean, it's not the only result. I mean, it's multi-parametric, just yes. So,
yes, it's from one work, but in another work,
different again.
I do not consider this graph as a final point.